Okay, all of you,
let's start, sir.
Welcome to today's session. So our respected resource person, Dr. A. Madhuri, Assistant Professor, Department of Microbiology, Government Degree College for Women, Autonomous Begumpet, Hyderabad. So today we have two sessions. Madam is going to conclude. Today is the last day for our mushroom cultivation class. So Madam has beat the final stroke, or the last what we can say, that final finishing touch. So that's why we are the very lucky people, and we are the lucky because of her huge experience regarding of this mushroom cultivation, especially microbiology. Madam has ready to complete today, because of madam has having some little bit of health problems. అయినప్పటికీ కూడా మేడం ఈ రోజు కంప్లీట్ చేయడానికి రెండు సెషన్లు అడిగారు. బి రెడీ మేడం, ప్లీజ్ యు స్టార్ట్ ద సెషన్.
Yes, sir. Yes. Good afternoon, participants. So today we have to deal with storage aspects of mushroom. So we have seen the production part, how what care we have to take at every step of mushroom production, and think that we have got the mushrooms. Okay, so after getting the mushrooms, what we have to do? We have to go for storage. Okay, how to store the mushrooms? First method is steeping preservation. Steeping means you are putting these mushrooms in some liquid, whether it is salt solution or it is a mixture of acids, some it may be acetic acid. With this kind of preservation, you can store the mushrooms for around 3 to 6 months. For this, first you have to clean the mushrooms, and you have to put it in the whatever solution you want. Okay, and different scientists have given different cocktail for steeping solutions. Means they have suggested mixture of different chemicals, like 2% sodium chloride, 2% citric acid, 2% sodium bicarbonate. All these things they can be added according to the type of mushroom what we want to preserve, and just you are dipping the mushrooms in that dilute solutions of these chemicals. See here, you can see this is the mushrooms, steeped mushrooms, and this can be stored in this way for 3 to 6 months. Next is drying. Drying is, we know it is a very old method. By this, what happens is moisture is removed from the mushrooms. Then by the loss of moisture, what happens is my bacteria or the microorganisms cannot grow in that. That is why these dried mushrooms can be preserved. Okay. And they can be dried at 55 to 60 degrees centigrade. And by drying mushrooms, we can use them in off season also. When this crop is not available, we can use them. And drying can be done by different methods: sun drying, air cabinet drying, dehumidified air cabinet drying, osmo air drying, freeze drying, fluidized bed drying, and microwave drying. So in these are all methods. They are very lengthy processes, okay, to explain, but I'm not going in detail with this methods. Just you can see here, this is the sun-dried mushrooms and these are the oven-dried mushrooms. Next is pickling. Pickling means, we know we prepare pickles at home, right? This is also a same process. In place of any other thing, we are using mushrooms. Mushrooms, we are making the pickle like other vegetables. And this is a long-term storage. By preparing pickles, we can store them for longer period, and they act as good appetizers. Usually people prefer to have pickle. So in that way, if they consume mushrooms, it will be very healthy for the people. And for preparing these pickles, you have to fry them till they become brown. First, you have to wash them. After that, slicing should be done, cutting. Then blanching means dipping in this solution and mixing of salt with blanched mushrooms. And then you have to keep it overnight. And then whatever water comes out, you have to remove that water. And then you have to mix with acetic acid, sodium benzoate, and other spices with these mushrooms. And then your pickle will be ready. So this is the mushroom pickle. And these are all the ingredients which are used for pickle preparation. Here you can see pickled mushroom. And next process is canning of mushroom. Canning means here, this is again a long-term procedure, long-term storage process. Here also, you have to wash the mushroom, cut it, and then you have to immerse in different solutions like KMS solution, citric acid solution, and then you have to fill this in plain cans. The word canning means you are filling this food material in can and then you are processing. Okay, so you have put these mushrooms in the can and then that can should be immersed in hot brine solution. What is this brine? NaCl solution. Okay, you are dipping that can in the brine solution and then removing it. Next, heating at 80 degrees temperature for 3 to 5 minutes. When you are putting it in the brine solution, how much temperature will be there? 80 degrees. How much time you have to put that can? Around 3 to 5 minutes. Then you have to remove it and then pressure processing. Then you have to autoclave and then labeling and storage. So this is the canning procedure. This is the canned mushrooms. If, as they are stored in the cans, then they are called as canned mushrooms. Next. So after this storage, you have to learn about packing. Okay, how to pack the mushrooms. See, there are two methods. One is packing of fresh mushrooms, right? If you are, whether you are washing it or not. Okay, first one is tray packing of mushrooms, tray packed button mushroom. This is the tray packed button mushroom. Usually the trays, what you are seeing, these blue trays, in these trays, they'll be keeping the mushrooms without washing. Packing you have seen, okay, very delicately you have to remove, you have to remove the mushrooms from the mushroom bags. Okay, after that, without washing, they will pack it in this trays. Okay, next, see this, these are all packed mushrooms where we are using some polythene bags. Here in this picture, you can see even mushroom, this vegetable vendors are also selling the mushrooms. And after harvesting the mushroom, you have to cut the stem. Like this, you have to cut the stem and then you have to pack it. After this, they are packed internally in the cartons. Next. Marketing of mushrooms. Here, marketing means first thing, what you have to understand here is, why we are talking about mushrooms is, one thing is it is healthy, and second thing is, it is also a source of livelihood. Okay, if people want to try, it can be a good source of livelihood for many people. Okay, 91% of people lying awake at night are worrying about health and money. Many people worry about their health, for which mushrooms can be an answer, and also money, for again, mushrooms can be an answer. So they can even earn using mushroom production, right? So in the initial years of our life, we forgot our health while going after wealth. In the later years of our life, we spend our wealth to take care of our health. This is the general scenario, right? We'll be very working very hard while we lose the health. And then to take care of health, we have to spend more money. So to balance these things, mushroom can be an option where we can get good health as well as good money, right? So how much, how we have to earn, what is this? Mushroom save life. If you see the nutritional aspect of the mushroom, it is like, it can cure many health problems, right? And if you talk about the money, these are the different countries who are making profit in dollars, billion dollar turnover, right? So why can't we do the same thing? Next, big opportunities of mushroom business. So everything we have to start with a small scale, this thing. There is an income opportunity using this mushroom production. There is health, wealth, and also happiness. And no stress, no risk. There is risk to some extent, but we can happily go with this process of mushroom production. Better life and social work. So we need not spend much time on this mushroom production daily. So we have some space to maintain our social relations also. And we can have some self-satisfaction with what we are earning and with what good we are doing to the society. And not high investment. Investment is not high where we can fear about loss. And independent business. It is independent business. We cannot depend on others. We need not work under someone. But huge support structure. If we can develop the structure properly, it can help us. Simple skills and knowledge required. It is very simple science where we can do or grow the mushrooms. Next concept of marketing. What is marketing? We have to make our product reach the consumer. Distribution channel. There should be some channel to sell these mushrooms. It may be through family or it may be through some firm or some retail shops, etc. And sharing your knowledge, whatever knowledge you are having, whether it is about the health benefits of the mushroom, you have to share with others so that others can understand the importance of mushrooms and so that they can go for purchasing of mushrooms and also with the mushroom cultivation. Why mushroom business? See, if you compare with the large-scale business, their investment will be very high, so the risk will be high, tension will be high. Here, the investment is less, maybe around 25,000. Workload, how many hours we have to work? Maybe 1 to 2 hours or 3 hours per day. That is the maximum. But for business, even if you work for 24 hours, you may feel tensed and you can't be sure of profits and loss risk. Risk will be only 5% because you are spending very little amount. So risk is also very less. Here, as you are putting more amount, risk will be more, about 50%. And health risk will also be more in large business compared to small business. And stress will be more in large business when compared to small business. And income will be 25,000 for a small business, whereas there may not be limit for a large business for monthly income, but there will be high risk. So like present times, there is more risk for our health. So we have to maintain our mental health as well as physical health. So we have to think in all these aspects. And if we go for mushroom cultivation, the income will be sufficient for our family while you are giving some good product for consumers. Next, product capacity. We have to determine what is the demand and how much supply should be there, how much production should be there. We have to decide on your own product positioning. We have to take care of hygienic packing and product pricing. Based on the market value, you can give your own price, and product quality you have to decide. And distribution channel, you have to make a plan how to distribute the product. And these are all marketing aspects where you have to work. And selling is an art and a profession. So selling a product is an art. So you have to be thorough at this art. You have to make the customer convinced about your product. And approach, you can approach your friends, relatives, institutions on the whole, and neighbors, some employment firms, even strangers also, we can approach, okay, and we can convince them for the mushroom sale. And this is all the same thing, okay. These are 5 C's to progress. You have to commit yourself, you have to consume, and you have to convince the customers, you have to communicate in a proper way, and you have to concentrate. So these are all are required for progress. And if you contact 100 people, maybe some people, they may not respond. Some people, they may reject. But ultimately, there will be few people who can listen to you and you can respond to you in a positive way. Take that into account. And if you sum up with all the positive responses, you can get a good income at the end of the month. So you have to develop some communication skills, how to talk to the customer, how to convince the customer. These are all part of skill development where we have to work. Okay. Next is we have to talk about recipes, right? Coming to the recipes part, we have prepared, like at home, we'll be preparing every day, we'll prepare new dish. So with mushroom also, like I believe many of us didn't had mushroom even at once in our lifetime. Okay, some may be there who have tasted it, but many of the Indians, I think they have not tasted. But it is a good thing tasty food, you have to give a try for this mushrooms. Okay, so what we have to prepare? We can prepare many things. You can prepare soups. Like this is the recipe for the preparation of soups. Here you can take shiitake mushroom, oyster mushroom, maitake mushroom. And even you can prepare great mushroom soup. This is another recipe. And then, see, and here nothing is there to explain here. Okay, chicken and mushroom cream soup. Like whatever way we like our food to be, you can replace anything in here. Like vegetables we are cooking, you have to use this mushrooms, then you can get the nutritious value. And taste is also good because recently I also have tried mushrooms. That is very, very much better than other vegetables. And even the cost is reasonable. And this is baked garlic mushroom recipe. See this? This is the recipe. And here biryani, you see this picture? It looks good. So whatever contents you are taking for the normal biryani preparation, the same contents will be there except the chicken or meat. So in that place, you have to use this mushrooms. And this is broccoli and mushroom steamed rice. You can prepare the steamed rice using mushrooms. And vegetable chats, you can prepare burgers and salads. You can prepare dried mushrooms. You can use.
Excuse me, madam. Madam, this slide is not moving.
Not moving.
Slides are not moving, madam. Only recipes. We are watching only recipes. First slide only.
Sorry.
Only first slide okay. We are watching. Please you once you. Scroll thoroughly. Okay.
Huh.
Right, madam.
So this is the soup, mushroom soup. Okay. This is another soup that is great mushroom soup.
Madam, and we here, want that soup. Shivarani madam, is there some other resource, some of the important excellent students, they are also waiting for this soup. When ready to cultivate these mushrooms and make these wonderful soups. Mushroom soup. Madam, please soup. Continue.
Yeah. So next we are having chicken and mushroom cream soup. Here they have added cream, whole cream, and even chicken pieces with along with the mushrooms. And this is the baked items, that is garlic mushroom recipe. See this dish, it is looking very good. And here mushroom biryani is there. In this, just you have to exclude the meat or chicken and you have to include the mushrooms. Rest all recipe is same. And broccoli and mushroom steamed rice. This is the steamed rice and this is the pizza. Even pizza you can make and vegetable chat, you can make burgers, you can make, and even you can prepare salads. See how it is looking. You have to just steam the mushroom and you have to mix it with the salads. And this is crab stuffed mushrooms. Means in crabs, they are putting this mushroom, maybe sliced mushrooms. Okay. So this is about recipes. So next is health benefits. We have to talk about health benefits here. So when we are having mushrooms, what is the? Since the first class, we are saying mushrooms are nutritious. Mushrooms are good to eat, right? So what is good in this? First thing is it is high in protein. How much protein is there? 72 to 83% protein. It is not a small thing. Okay, it is highly nutritious, highly proteinaceous. Okay, and 46.5% dry weight protein is there in Agaricus bisporus, and these are all protein contents in other mushrooms, and they all contain essential amino acids. Carbohydrates are 50 to 65%. On dry weight basis, and free sugar are 11%. Mannitol, 80% is there. Raffinose, sucrose, glucose, fructose, xylose are also present in Agaricus bisporus. and these are water-soluble polysaccharides of mushrooms are anti-tumor, means these carbohydrates, they are acting against cancer. Tumor means cancer. Okay, next, fat. Here, fat percent is around 2% in different mushrooms and rich in linoleic acid. It is an essential fatty acid which is present in mushrooms. And vitamins, it contains different vitamins such as vitamin B, vitamin D2, and vitamin A, B, and E. Mushrooms are also containing vitamin C in small amounts. So it is a multivitamin kind of thing. And minerals are also present such as potassium, phosphorus, sodium, calcium, magnesium, copper, zinc, etc. So many minerals are present. You have to definitely go for this food. And medicinal value, it is anti-allergic. If you have any allergy, it can be removed. Anti-cholesterol. If you have cholesterol, it can act against it. Anti-tumor means anti-cancer. And it is acting on skin diseases. And it is helping in treating AIDS. And it is having beta-D-glucans, which is having an anti-tumor polysaccharide, which was named lentinan. Okay, so beta-D-glucans is named as lentinan. It is an anti-tumor compound. And it is also working on epilepsy, that means leprosy, wounds, skin diseases, heart ailments, heart problems, rheumatoid arthritis, and cholera, besides intermittent fevers. Cholera means waterborne disease, and diaphoretic, diarrhea, dysentery, cold, anesthesia, liver diseases. See the list of the diseases where it can work. Okay, and it is also used as vermicides. So it can, in underdeveloped countries, it can overcome the problem of malnutrition. In many children in remote areas, they are usually undernourished or malnutrition is there. So if you can provide mushrooms for them, this malnutrition can be overcome in such cases. And it is also known to lower blood pressure and serum cholesterol. Nowadays, many people are suffering with this high blood pressure. Okay, so if they try these mushrooms, there can be benefit. And they are proved that this lentinus, tigrinus, and lucidum are proved anti-cholesterolomic. They are acting on the cholesterol content. And this mushroom, Lentinus edulcus, is also enhancing vigor, sexuality, energy as an anti-aging agent. Okay. See, many people nowadays are concentrating on anti-aging products like creams and something else. So even mushrooms are also acting on that area. Next, Lentinus sulfate. Lentinus sulfate from Lentinus species. It is inhibiting HIV virus, regression of the disease state. So it is somewhat helping to stop the disease progression. Okay. Maitake extract has been shown to kill HIV. Even work has been done where they found that some extract of this maitake mushroom is killing this HIV virus and enhancing the activity of T helper cells. If you know about HIV, this HIV virus will attack the T helper cells. Okay. So if you take this mushroom extract, right, it is known, it is seen that this extract is working on HIV virus. It is killing the virus and it is helping in increasing of the helper cells, which are the fighters of our body. And Ganoderma nutraceuticals have exhibited promising antiviral effects like anti-hepatitis B, anti-HIV. So this mushroom is also showing some antiviral properties. Mushrooms like reishi, cardo, cypress, enoki, etc., they are working on cancer treatment, asthma, and allergy treatment. So scientists are working on this benefits of mushrooms. And some of them are proved. So they are also working on high blood pressure, smallpox, asthma. They have given with the name of the mushroom, which one is working. Okay. Even it is acting as a probiotic bacteria and Cordyceps sinensis is also treated. Half caterpillar and half mushroom has been known and used for centuries in traditional Chinese medicine. Means directly they are using this mushroom for treatment. And it is also helping to induce restful sleep. See, many of us won't have proper sleep nowadays. Okay, so if we have this mushrooms, that is cordyceps, we can sleep soundly and acts as an anti-cancer, anti-aging, and anti-asthma agents, and it is also improving the memory and sexual rejuvenator. See, I don't think there is any disease which is not listed here. It is acting on many areas of our health. Okay, so definitely there is a we should try this. Okay, antioxidant activity of mushrooms. So these mushrooms are also acting as antioxidants. Antioxidants usually act on free radicals. Free radicals, they are unstable molecules which will be generated in our body whenever there is a damage. Okay, so usually we like doctors prefer that you have to take for antioxidants and all. So these mushrooms are also having antioxidant activity. We can reduce our oxidative stress by consuming these mushrooms, and again it is acting on the cancer tissue. This mushroom. So we are done with this medicinal properties of mushrooms.
Madam.
Yes, sir. We have almost ended the contents. We have almost covered all the topics. Now only three slides are left. You are able to see the slide, right?
So yeah, here, this slide in is visible. Yes, madam. It is visible. Slide,
yeah. We can see the nutritional properties of mushrooms, where you can compare the protein content, fat content, and unsaturated fat, polyunsaturated fat, total unsaturated fat, saturated fat, carbohydrates, and complex carbohydrates. This is the nutritional profile of different mushrooms. See the protein content. Okay, this is the highest. Okay, and this is the fat. Fat content is very less. Carbohydrate content, usually people say that mushrooms are good, ideal food for the diabetic patients. Okay, and culinary mushrooms. Here, these mushrooms here, we can see the calories, what energy they are giving. And these are the calcium, copper, iron, potassium, sodium, selenium content in different mushrooms. Comparatively, we can check with different mushrooms. And here, you can see nutritional properties where you can see the fiber content, thiamine, B2, B1, B2, B3, and pantothenic acid, B5, vitamin C content and vitamin D content. See, vitamin C is zero, but others they are present in all the mushrooms. This is the important slide. Okay, we believe that we should have vegetables, but this slide shows mushrooms are more better than other vegetables. If you compare the protein content, here this is the protein. Mushrooms, it is around 26 to 27. In which vegetable there is more protein here? Here, cauliflower. Cauliflower is having 28.8. Others, green peas, they are having lima beans. Okay, so green peas and cauliflower is having, and only cauliflower is having more than mushrooms. Other vegetables, the protein content is very less. Okay, and carbohydrates, some proteins, the carbohydrate is high, like lima beans and beetroot. In mushrooms, it is 4.4%. And fat is also less. Moisture is very high in mushrooms. And calories-wise, if you take, it is giving least calories, that is 16 calories. Nowadays, we are looking for low-calorie food, right? So mushrooms are best ideal for such a persons who are looking for low-calorie dish, low-calorie foods. Okay. So with this, I want to wind up today's session. Thank you for your patient listening. I thank Tirupati sir for giving this chance, having trust in me, and giving some big responsibility of covering a large portion of the certificate course. Thank you so much, sir. And I also thank the management of GDC Jagithyal for this opportunity.
So with this class, we hope all the participants, they are very happy. They are giving their feedback in my personal WhatsApp. Okay. They are very happy with your lectures, madam. And also, this one table shows about how the mushroom, the content, the fiber content, the calories, and different nutrients, along with this protein content. So this is this table is enough to why we are intaking of the mushroom, why we are going to cultivate this mushroom. So compared to moisture, compared to protein content, compared to fat content, mushroom is highly useful for our today's scenario. So in the context of the health benefits, mushroom is very, very suitable for the stress and the anxiety conditions. So that's why the moisture is high moisture content is there. Then calories is less calories. So here potato and lima beans, even though the other vegetables, they contain the calories, higher calories here. But mushroom is very less calories. So in America, even though the developed countries, they are not knowingly or unknowingly insert their digestive tract. They are using every day how much calories they are intaking the food material. They are not weighed by the kilos and what we can say the quintals. They are measured only by calories. But in our India, we are half kg or kg or 2 kg, whatever it may be. So this is our great India. Why? Because we are in a tropical region, you know. So that's why that's not a matter, but mushroom is very useful. So finally, I would like to invite today's participants, especially madam is, I hope madam is not there. Shivarani madam is there, na? No. So madam is very regular participant. So madam, I hope she is left from our session. Renuka or Vaishnavi, cheptarama edana maatladtara meeru? Anybody? Manasa? No? Okay, madam, thank you very much for your interactive, very live and interactive sessions regarding of these 5 units. You are covered more than 2 units of our mushroom cultivation. We are very lucky because of your sessions of this mushroom cultivation. Without you, we cannot the perfection. We cannot give the perfection of this mushroom cultivation. So your final finishing touch is very interesting and highly useful. So we hope regarding of our college, regarding of our departments, regarding of this certificate course, we are wholeheartedly thankful to you, madam, Dr. A. Madhuri madam garu. So actually, this pandemic situation and your personal problem and health problem, your mother health condition, you are spare your time for making up these slides more than what we can say that from early morning, 3 o'clock onwards, you are searching new slides for the giving a new information or any innovative information regarding of this lecture. So that's why we are wholeheartedly thankful to you, madam. In front of us, the another one of the big task is in front of us. So I am very happily and also thankful to you, and requesting you, please, you like this certificate course. We will conclude the another big task also, madam garu. So that's why I am also personally requesting you whenever. Within a week, definitely you will give your valuable time for giving your sessions for the online coaching for plant sciences. Thank you very much, madam.
Sure, sir. Thank you, sir. Thank you.
Right.